All right, today we're going to talk about the new update of HarmonyOS Next to 5.1. It has been rolled out on phones, pads and computers. It started rolling out a couple of days ago and it will continue roll out during the next 2 weeks. I have updated all my devices, so let's go through the most exciting things about the update and let's see if it can live up to the hype. HarmonyOS Next 5.1, let's go. So let's start with the MateBook Pro. So the update basically is a bunch of small updates. I think the big one is GrabShot, which is something I mentioned in my previous video about the MateBook Pro that was missing. Now it's here. I will show you. I will also show you here. This is when you have an external display, you can now change the interface to have it small, medium or large. As you see, I changed this and then in the next screen you will see how it changes on the TV, the external screen. Okay, so now let's look at the famous grab shot. You have seen this. So now we have it on the computer as well. So I can grab a screenshot, drop a screenshot, grab a screenshot, drop a screenshot. It's really cool. It's very handy on the phones and the pad. Not sure how much I'm gonna use it on the computer, but I'm glad it's there. It feels complete now. Another famous feature is the flick your wrist to scroll. You can scroll up and down. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of this one, but it works, but it's very finicky. So maybe let's move on to the MatePad. So I think it's the same here. There's not that huge updates. I will show you two of them. I will show you the calendar enhancement where you have the daily what happened today in history, and I will show you the multi-display support where you can have multiple apps in the same kind of viewing container. Let's first start with that one. So here I'm gonna open three different apps, so I can put this one in the multi container, drag it up, and you see here now I have two. Now drag this one up, oh, and now I can add a third one, and now I have kind of a tiled three apps running at the same time. It's really nice, very convenient. And now I can add a fourth one. But the fourth one, it cannot display at the same time as the other three. So you see it's on the left here. I can resize this and then it depends. So now I kind of drag Bmol to the right, to the left, and then... And I cannot add a fifth one here. It's blocking me. So when we open the calendar here, now I want to see the today in history. So on the left here, I can go to the add-ons and manage. And here you have the three add-ons we have. And you see down to the left here, we have today in history. So this shows me what happened today. It's really good if you're like quiz, you can go in and check. This is obviously in Chinese right now. Can you see, let's translate it and see what this is. If this is just Chinese happenings or if it's international one. And you can see here, for example, we have some Chinese guys who are born and dead, and but we also have like French fashion designer Yves Saint Laurent. So this is kind of global events. Very interesting. I like this, especially I do a lot of quiz, so every time I go to a quiz I have to check this before, because there will always be a question about what happened today. So that's it for the MatePad. So let's move on to the phones now. I will not show the Pura X because it's very similar to the Mate 70. So, without further ado, let's move on to the phones. So the first thing we have up is the new theme. This is the Fluffy. He was released for the Pura80. It was kind of the mascot. So you can interact with him a little bit, nothing special. It can be a fun little guy to play with. You can customize and so on. But yeah, nothing special. So let's look at the new gallery widget. So now there is a gallery widget which you can add here, boom, like that. You have different layouts. Let's pick the middle one, like so. You can configure it so it has a slideshow, basically 15 seconds or 13. You can select album or photo. That's basically it. It stays here. Not a huge improvement, I don't know. But yeah, as you can see, it switches. That's nice. So next up, let's look at a feature which already existed on the Pura 80, the Pura 80 Ultra. So this one is move feature in the gallery. So let's go here. Let's go back to the photos. Let's go to this one. So here now you can let's see here. If we edit the photo with AI retouch and go to move, we can mark this guy here. Let's see, let's mark the eagle too. And then boom. We can make a copy of him, move him. This guy we can move. And we can make him smaller. Oh, let's see here. Boom. So now we have three Indian eagle hunters. Or Kazakh. But I think this guy was an Indian cosplayer. Looks pretty cool, right? Let's see here. Generate. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, right. As you can see, compare here. So I love this feature. It's a really cool one. Yeah, so that's it for the gallery move, or the AI retouch move. Another feature is Creative Studio, which is a similar feature. This one has been implemented across the board, but I will show it on the Mate 70. So what this is it's a agent that can generate pictures. So I prepared three examples here. So the first example is Undertaker, WWE hero, with a full trench coat, hat and urn, solemnly giving a dramatic eulogy for a busted Roomba while a choir of rubber ducks sing Amazing Grace inside a miniature wrestling ring. So, I don't know, you tell me what you think. I don't think this guy looks like the Undertaker, the character, but yes, he's big, he has his urn. Oh, that's an urn, I thought it was a cup first, a prize cup, but no. Pretty good. And we have number two, Gordon Ramsay furiously trying to bake the perfect souffle inside a bouncy castle using paintball. No, during a paintball fight with hyperactive toddlers. So you see this one isn't like cartoonish. That doesn't look like Gordon Ramsay really. This one looks more. This one looks like Gordon Ramsay, I would say. It's pretty specific. And the last one is The Rock knitting a scarf out of spaghetti during a wrestling match with a grizzly bear wearing sunglasses under a disco ball of tacos. So I think this one is pretty good. We have the disco ball with tacos. We have Dwayne The Rock knitting a spaghetti scarf. A bear with sunglasses. Similar, but this is cartoon. And this one is... I don't know where it's this one. I think it looks like a buff Will Smith in this one, but yeah. But it's good. Okay, so that's it for the Mate 70. Let's move on to the Pura 80 Ultra. Okay, so the Pura 80 Ultra got another update. It got two new companion themes to the fluffy theme. So we have Bouncy and Dusty. They are basically the same. The difference is you can blow on like this and they will disappear. But other than that, I think they are very similar. I like Dusty though. I think he looks cooler than Fluffy and Bouncy. So there's not that much extra, but there is one new feature that I really like, and that is it's similar to the move feature, but now you can move between photos. So, for example, let's take this photo as a background. And now when I edit this one, I can go to AI retouch, and instead of going move, I go move. But now I use sticker. And then I can import from another photo. So now I can take this guy, the Indian guy, put him in a new photo. I can take I can take my dog. Put him in the photo too. Maybe he's over here. Coming in like that from the top. And let's see what else we have. Maybe this tree here. This alcohol Christmas tree. And let's take this one and put it here, yeah. This one is a really nice feature. I really like this one. It's fun. Really fun to play with. So I'm happy. I guess this feature will come to the other ones later. But right now, this one is only on the Pura 80. I love it. I've been playing around with it the whole day. So this one is awesome. I really like it. Let's see. Let's generate this photo and see how it looks. So you got the shadow of the everything, yeah. That's a nice one. Really nice. So in conclusion, I think there is a lot of cool new features. It's moving, but maybe it's a bit of a lackluster update. I think a lot of people were excited about 5.1. So was I. But the features might not be that groundbreaking. I think we probably have to wait for 6.0 for that, but it's moving along, and it's fun that I can see now that since the Pura 80 is basically a version ahead of that one, I can now it's going crazy, but that means that there are cool things coming to the other devices later, so stick around. I think we will have nice updates in the future here. So I think that's it for this video. It's a shorter one. I've been traveling for a couple of weeks, so that's why I haven't uploaded anything. But now I'm back, so hopefully we can get back with more videos soon. See you next one. Bye bye.